Assalamu alaikum students. In the previous lecture, we defined open spheres and closed spheres. We studied that in the metric space of real numbers, an open sphere is just an open interval and a closed sphere is a closed interval. And in the metric space R2, an open sphere is an open circle, whereas a closed sphere in R2 is a closed circle. And in the discrete metric space, an open sphere is either a singleton set or the whole discrete metric space. So in today's lecture, we are going to study interior points and interior of a set inside a metric space. So our topic is interior points and interior of a set inside a metric space. So let us first of all define an interior point of a set. Interior point. So let XD be a metric space and AB any subset of X then a point A belonging to the set A is called an interior point of the set A if there exists a real number R greater than 0, positive real number R, such that SR at A is contained inside the set A. Okay. So what is this definition saying about interior point? That we are considering any subset A of a metric space X and A is an element of any element of that set, then that element is called an interior point of A, okay, if we can draw an open sphere centered at that point A with radius R, okay. So if in a set, if we can draw an open sphere around any point of that set, then that point is said to be interior point of that set. So now let us explain this with an example. So let us consider the metric space, which is our usual metric space, the metric space of real numbers. And let the set A, which is a subset, set A be equal to, for example, this interval 3, 7, which is the set of all real numbers from 3 to 7 or all real numbers between 3 and 7. Okay, so this is our real line. So this is 3 and suppose this is 7. Okay, so this is our set. Now we will locate the interior points of this set. So let's talk about the number 4 over here, which belongs to this set. Okay. So is 4 an interior point of this set? So according to this definition, any point of the set will be an interior point if we can draw an open sphere around that point and if that open sphere lies in that particular set. So here you can see that if I draw an open sphere around 4 of any suitable radius, suppose if I take the radius of sphere as suppose 1 by 2 or 0.5. Okay. So I will add 0.5 to 4 and I will subtract 0.5 from 4 to draw the sphere. Okay. So the sphere will lie over here. 4 plus 0.5 is 4.5. So 4.5. And here 4 minus 0.5, which is 3.5. So this is 3.5. So this is the open sphere around 4. And as you can see that this open sphere lies in this set, which is the set of all dual numbers between 3 and 7. So this open sphere around 4 lies in this set. So 4 is an interior point of this set according to this definition. And how about 6? Is 6 an interior point? Yes. What is the difference between 6 and 7? So this distance is 1. Okay, if I choose a sphere with a radius again 0.5, then that sphere will be from 5.5 to 6.5, and that sphere again lies in this set. So 6 is also an interior point of this set. And how about 3 and 7? So we are not going to consider 3 and 7 because these points don't belong to this set. Okay. So we take only those points which belong to the set for interior points. So here you can see that if I take any point greater than 3 and less than 7, that will be an interior point. And the set of all the interior points of a set is called its interior. Okay, so what is an interior? So interior of a set, the set of all the interior points of a set. A, suppose, is called an interior of A, denoted by A naught. Okay, so this is the interior of the set A. For example, for this set A, which is the set of all real numbers between 3 and 7, you can see that every real number between 3 and 7 is an interior point of this set. Okay. So the interior of this set A will be, so interior of for this set will be equal to 3, 7, which is equal to itself. Now let us take some more examples of sets and identify interior points and interiors of those sets. So again, let us consider a set A. Now this time, suppose set is 3, 7 closed interval. Okay, now 3 and 7 are also elements of this set A. Okay, so this is the real line. This is 3, this is 7. Now, as we have already checked that any point which is greater than 3 or less than 7 is an interior point. But how about 3 and 7? if we take 3, is 3 an interior point for this set? So for example, if taking 3 as center, I draw any sphere around it, no matter how small, since 3 is the first point, so no matter how small radius I take, I will go beyond that set. So I will go out of that set. So 3 cannot be an interior point. Similarly, if I take 7 as center and draw an open sphere around 7, no matter how small radius I take, I go beyond or out of this set. So again, 7 is also not an interior point. Okay. So for this set, again, the set of interior points or the interior of this set will be the set of all the points greater than 3 and less than 7. So for this set, again, A naught will be 3, 7 open interval. So in general, if our set A is any open interval AB, then its interior is always the same open set. And if the set A is a closed interval, then its interior is the open interval AB. And if A is this interval, AB, here A is included but B is not, so again its interior will also be equal to AB. Similarly, if A is AB, again interior of this set A is AB. Okay, now we will take some more sets inside our usual metric space, which is the metric space of real numbers, and we'll identify their interior points and their interior sets. Now, how about the set of natural numbers, n, the set of naturals? Let us explore the interior points of this set. So, the set n is this set with elements 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So, for example, if I take 1 and see if it is an interior point of this set or not. So if I take 1 as center and draw any radius of no matter how small radius, I basically go out of this natural number. So if I subtract anything, no matter how small, from 1, then that thing will not belong to the set of natural numbers. So it means any sphere around 1 will not lie in this set. So this means that 1 is not an interior point. Similarly, if I add anything, no matter how small, to 1, then that element will also not be in this set, because the element after 1 is 2, then 3. So there are no numbers in between. So again, 2, 3, 4. So all these points are not interior points. So this means that the set of natural numbers has no interior points. So the set N has no interior points. Okay, so this means that interior of the set of natural numbers is an empty set. So what is the interior of this set? So it means, so for n, so what is n naught? So n naught is just an empty set. So there is no interior point for the set of natural numbers. And how about the set of integers? Z. Okay, so again Z, as you know, that consists of zero positive integers, natural numbers, and then negative numbers. So again, no point of the set of integers is an interior point. For example, if I choose 3, no matter how small radius sphere I draw around 3, then that sphere will not lie in this set. That sphere will not belong to this set. So it means, again, the set of integers also doesn't have any interior points. So Z has no interior points. And how about the set of rational numbers Q? The set of rational numbers. So, for example, on the real line, if I choose any number and if I draw a sphere around that number of any radius, then I can get the numbers which are either rational or irrational. Okay, so irrational numbers are not present inside rational numbers. Okay, so if I draw any sphere around this point A, so I can get irrational numbers as well. Okay, so that is why the set of rational numbers does not have any interior points. So again, no interior points. And how about the set of real numbers R? Okay, now the set of real numbers. So if on this real number line, if I choose any real number and draw a sphere around that number, that is by adding or subtracting any number R to this point by drawing a sphere around it, then that sphere will definitely lie inside this real line. Okay, so that sphere will be a subset of the set of real numbers. So this means that every real number is an interior point of the set of real numbers. So every real number is an interior point. So for R, so every real number is an interior point. Of R. So it means that for R, interior of R is equal to R. It means the interior of the set of real numbers is the set of real numbers itself, because every real number is an interior point. So we can draw an open sphere around every real number on the number line. And as far as the discrete metric space is concerned, you know that if in the discrete metric space, if we take the radius greater than 1, then an open sphere will be the whole discrete metric space. So in this case, every point of the discrete metric space will be an interior point. And if the radius is less than 1 or equal to 0, then the open sphere will be a singleton set, okay, and there will be only one interior point in that case. And the interior of any subset of the discrete metric space will consist of only one point. So in today's lecture, we studied interior points in interior of a set. Okay, if for any element of any subset of the metric space, if we draw a sphere around that point, and if that sphere lies in the set, then that point is called an interior point. And the set of all the interior points of a set is called its interior. Hence, we have illustrated these concepts with examples as well. So, see you in the next lecture.